Tana, it is one of the most anticipated note-taking apps of all time, and it is now launched and in the wild. Today, I'm going to give you everything you need to know about Tana to see whether it's your next note-taking app. Tana is a complicated application. It wants to be somewhere where you can plan your notes, but also your tasks, capture your meetings, and much, much more. So I'm going to make this super simple and understandable with all the information that you need to know. So welcome. If you're new here to the channel, please do subscribe. It'd be amazing to have you. And if you're hunting for note-taking apps in general, and maybe you're watching this video or even after it, still curious, then you can download our buyer's guide to note-taking apps, which you can find linked below. This video will be more of an overview of Tana to see whether it's right for you. If you're looking for resources and best courses about Tana, you can find that linked below. Now, first of all, I don't know whether I'm saying Tana right. It could be Tana or Tana. I think it's Tana. But, you know, badger me in the comments to see whether I'm saying it right. And maybe I'll say it multiple times in this video. So this application is primarily a note-taking software. Now, it's actually not only for individuals, but also teams too. So they can download this on a wide range of devices. You can download it on mobile with iOS and Android, as well as on desktop, including web and Linux as well. It makes it one of the most cross-platform notes app out there. Now, in terms of pricing, Tana is not cheap in terms of its pricing when you want to go pro. So they have a free plan, but you do need to start a pro trial and cancel it in order to go on the free plan, if that makes sense. You then are able to upgrade if you did fancy it in the future. The pro pricing for yearly is $8 per month, which is a little bit more expensive than others. And there is an additional tier at $14 per month. Now, this isn't a cheap note-taking app, but that gives you unlimited access to all of the majority of features in Tana, and I'll include all the details of that below. Now, before we begin, a lot of people ask me some of the basic things. Is Tana open sourced? And the answer is no. I did some research and found that there's no open source nature to this app. Is it local first? No, Tana's not local first. It's pretty much web access and uses some AI technologies to help you save time. So now we've got the meat and bones out of the way. A lot of people asked me that sort of stuff before. Let's look at Tana itself and let's go over some of the basic features to see whether it's right for you. So as you can see here, this is Tana, and it is a very interesting application. So the first thing is you get a today area, and the today area is really nice because you can see you got today, but you also can start bullet pointing things. They're called nodes, basically adding things like tasks, things like notes, whatever you want, and you can expand them as well. It's like an outliner application if you've not used those before, like Workflowy and Dynalist. So you can expand on each of the nodes that you create and build on them in the future. You can also see any references to today down here if you have any. So here you have two things. You have an open tasks area, which is tasks that have been opened, which are perfect for just being able to see what you need to do and that are associated to today. You can also down here see an agenda, and when you get started, you can hit connect with Google Calendar. I'll come back to that a little bit more later. So very interestingly, Tana has a few features that are quite nice, but I'm going to start with the basics. Now, every time you do something, you can add something called a super tag. Now, super tags are basically objects. So if you've not heard of an object-based note-taking app, it essentially creates an object so you can reuse it again. But in Tana's case, with each of the different hashtags you add to it, it instantly creates an area for you. So this is really helpful when you're trying to give it something like a task, and it creates its own task area. So this is perfect for going into your tasks area and managing a calendar, which allows you to plan ahead, or going into the cards area. There's a lot of different views. Think of this as a way to turn any of your objects into a dashboard, a way for you to manage it in a database for later to customize it even more. So you can pretty much tag whatever you like, and you add it at the end of each of the nodes that you create to help build on it. So folks, if you're interested in getting 3 new tools in your inbox every single week, I'm gonna send them to you. And they're ones that I think are new and noteworthy. So if you're interested in that, you can sign up to the newsletter below and discover 3 new tools every week. On with the video. So the other thing you can do is obviously create the chat, the daily chat. And what's nice as well is you can use this Ask AI feature, which is essentially a chat that lives alongside everything you do. You can use that node as context for example, what you want to ask. So you could say, what do I have to do today? And what do I need to make sure I get done, for example. So as you can see there, you can naturally bring that in. And all of the AI chats are saved for your context in the future. And this is a really helpful experience. So coming back to the Google Calendar side, if you've got a calendar event that has been created as part of Google Calendar, what you can actually do is get a note created automatically. This is great for taking notes for the future, but also planning ahead. So here is a meeting that I created earlier. And what's nice is everything is automatically tagged. So in this case, an attendee is a person and it will automatically bring that into your system. There's also a way to connect something called an AI meeting agent, which can join your meeting, transcribe the meeting, and then it comes back to Tana and basically breaks it down into tasks, event status, and everything that you need to know about the meeting, which is an incredibly valuable thing to have, and it's all plugged into the same software. Now, I assume that when the agent comes into the meeting, it's just a Google Meet or something like that, a plugin that works in the background. And essentially, what it will do is during a call, transcribe it and then process the meeting notes. So just be careful and aware of what you want to choose to use in this case. So we talked very briefly about the task management side of stuff. You could essentially use this as project management too. You could use this by going to the calendar and seeing all the different viewing options. For in this case, you can use a list view, table view, a card view, and a calendar view. You can also see the tabs that you're working on as well, which is a helpful way to break down and filter through what you're doing. For example, here's one I created earlier, where it basically has all my tasks on this left-hand side, and you can customize it and filter it much like you do with Notion databases. So how does the AI come into it? Well, you've got the chat abilities, but you also have a way that you can automate some AI elements. For example, if you're in a team and you want to use it as a way to create a draft from the context provided for each of the notes you take about an article, you can actually do that. So you can set up these custom prompts inside of the different chats that you have and templates that you build in Tana, which could potentially save you a lot of time as a team building and populating information as part of your Tana account. And of course, then that's great for sharing and collaborating with other people. So there are other abilities as well, like on the mobile device, you can transcribe in real time. And that's a powerful feature that can not only be good for creating articles, but also using your voice to organize things. Something I'll probably cover in a separate video fully. So we touched on a lot of the capabilities of Tana in this video. And of course, not all of them in this video can be covered. It's just so big and so powerful, this application. And there's loads of different workflows as well. So I would point you towards a few other creators that are making great Tana content, which I'll link in the description below, as well as any course information that can help learn it. But who is Tana most suitable for? Well, I would say this isn't necessarily for people who are using lightweight note-taking apps. Those who are using maybe a Obsidian or a Logseq or something else like that in the PKM space, I think this app can really even go that step further and introduce more artificial intelligence into your daily routine. This is much more of not just a note-taking app. It's also got open tasks, agenda abilities, and with the live transcription can be an incredibly helpful way to save time. So I would probably target this towards more busy professionals that want a note-taking app that is reliable, robust, requires a little bit of learning, of course, and has some powerful capabilities as you optimize it as you go on, if that makes sense. So Tana is an incredibly interesting software that I will hopefully be doing some more content on. So if you enjoyed this video and you would like to help explain it to other people, then do share it with them. And of course, I would love to help you find new tools and software. So do jump over to toolfinder.co to explore more. Thanks very much. Hopefully we got everything you need to know about Tana in less than 10 minutes. Thank you.